Project Restart. This is a good one. So, the Premier League are considering restarting, right? Sometime I think between June and July. I think the government is sort of giving them a soft go ahead. You hear loads of reports that some people in the government are saying that, oh, if we get things started back up again in football, it's going to raise the sentiment of the nation. People are going to have a bit more feel good factor around, which is, a little bit, it's a little bit infantile and, just naive to think that people will forget about the pain and the hardship they've gone through just because someone's kicking the ball into a net. I love football as much as anybody, but I'm not under any illusion that people are really suffering out there. And football, if anything, is just going to further remind them of just how fucked up their life is, right? And just how different it's going to be for, for the foreseeable future. I think if anything, if you want to raise people's spirits and get their morale up, you invent a vaccine ASAP, or you roll out testing quicker to more people in disadvantaged areas. That'll probably get people's morale up. But regardless, the government are floating this idea out there, and it seems like all the Premier League clubs are pushing for the Premier League to restart. Now, if you look into the details, you'll find out there's a lot of money on the line due to the TV rights, something close to 1 billion, if not just under. I've heard 700 million floated around, 800, but whatever it is, it's a lot of zeros. And the Premier League doesn't want to be in a position where they're having to pay back any money or being penalised or being taken to court. They don't want that noise, or they don't want that smoke. And a lot of the Premier League clubs, even though they get a lot of money through sponsorships and brand deals, most of their revenue comes, especially if you're outside the top six, comes from the gate receipts, right? The ticket sales and anything else that you attach to that stadium. That's where you make your big, big, big bucks on. So a lot of those clubs want the football to come back too. But then it's an interesting position that some of the players in the lower leagues, the ones who probably have a lot more autonomy in terms of where they take their careers, people maybe in the top 10, maybe just below that, have kind of voiced their concerns about coming back, And the rationale, I think, behind them, I think we're going to read an article now from Troy Deeney, but the basic premise of their argument is, if it's not safe enough for fans to come in the stadium, why should players be expected to play? Which is a fair enough argument to make. I guess if you're Dana White, you're going to tell them to get kicking the ball straight away because, you run the rule. But I guess the fact that they've got the PFA, they've got all these individual bodies, have to get approval from FIFA. Not for, is it FIFA or UEFA? I don't think UEFA has a say, actually. It's just the Premier League that decide or the FA decide, right? There's a lot of unions and associations representing players' interests who are kind of speaking up and making sure their voices are heard. Captains are playing a big role in it. It's getting a little bit tetchy, and you feel as if it's going to reach a point where we might effectively see football restarting, which I think they're going to do regardless. I wouldn't really want it to come back. I think you should just null and void the season, or do that whole simulated thing with the season where you just award Liverpool the title and sort out the rest via a computer. That might be a good way to go about things, but just restarting it for the sake of it doesn't make any sense. If you give them the title, you're annoying null and void the season. But Troy Deeney has something to say about it. Let's go to his article before I start rambling on. So this is from BBC News. It says here, Premier League project restart. Troy Deeney and Grant Hanley raise concerns. Watford captain Troy Deeney says he's not going to put his family at risk amid concerns that he's about the Premier League's plans to restart the season. The Shaka 31 said he would not play if he felt like he was putting his family in health in jeopardy. His concerns were echoed by Norwich captain Grant Hanley, who said he would be worried about returning home to his pregnant partner. And that's something I've said a lot, I think, previously in my other episodes, about the fact that the longer this went on, especially football players mostly, and some people in Hollywood. There's got an article here from, I'll read to you later, about Matt Damon, who's now, I think, in Ireland because he was filming something, but he's got a lot of family out there and he's now fell in love with the country and he might move. And then the stories of Chris Hemsworth lives in Australia with his family. He gets to avoid all the Hollywood paparazzi and gets to raise his kids in a semi-normal environment. I think for people, I must simply fall in, but I think for a lot of entertainers and athletes, spending this time away from their sport, whilst they're probably still getting paid quite handsome anyway from their sponsors and doing maybe some Instagram postings here and there, they're probably realizing that, the amount of training and stress they go through probably isn't as worth it as they thought it was. and their priorities change, right? Spending time at home with your family, reconnecting. Maybe, you know, some players have that thing where they've legitimately haven't seen their newborn child in maybe a couple of months. They get to connect with them. There's a different kind of bond developing because they're seeing them at home all the time. It's definitely going to change a lot of players' perspective, because I think, you know, even everyday people, you know, everyday folk are going to look at the situation we're going through, and they're going to be like, you know what, do I want to work in the job that I'm doing now? Do I want to keep pursuing this career? Or do I want to make a bit of a shift, a change? It's no different to a football player. They're also going to do the same thing. And I think the fact that the league weren't in communication with the players on a regular basis, that kind of gap in time gave those players a lot of time to think. And now they're thinking and they're really trying to assess it. They obviously come to a point where they're like, you know what, this doesn't make any sense. Why are we expected to go back to work under these conditions, especially in England, right? We've got some of the second highest death rate, I think, in the world. And look how small our country is. So if you're a Premier League player, you're worrying your rights to raise those concerns up and even question the fact that, you know, we're going out to, I think he might mention it here in an article, but, you know, the idea that you're going out to be at, smash on pots and pans, do clap, you know, clap for the NHS at 8 p.m, but then you're allowing Premier League players to play, you know, for two matches a week, and then using up the, you know, medical resources that are needed to, you know, to give to regular civilians. That's not necessarily something that's going to sit well with a lot of players who, have charities maybe giving money to hospitals and stuff. They're not going to think, it's not going to be a good look for them regardless. Let's continue with the article here. It says both players were involved in the talks with the Premier League this week. A conference call took place on Wednesday between the players and the league medical staff and the Professional Football Association to discuss Project Restart. On the Thursday, the government said it was opening the door for the return of professional football in June. The Premier League hopes that the return to action on the 12th on the 12th of June, with matches played behind closed doors. It says here, continues, I said, I'm not even talking about football at the moment. I'm talking about my family's health, Dini said on Instagram. I'm not looking after my family, then I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to put my family at risk. What are they going to do? Take money off me? I've been broke before, so it doesn't bother me. That's a really great line, actually, isn't it? Because I guess there's maybe the threat of the Premier League penalising him because he refused to turn up, or maybe his club doing the same thing, because, you know, maybe it's just in the rules. They're going to have to just penalise players. They don't decide to go to training. But there are these are extenuating circumstances. I'm sure he could argue with his lawyer or with his representatives that, you know, they haven't necessarily created a safe environment for him to go back to. And especially, I'd imagine, if you've got a newborn kid, the last thing you want to do is to put a newborn baby who's just come into the world at risk by deciding to go kick a ball in there. It just isn't that important. Again, maybe because the UFC has restarted, it's putting pressure on some of these sporting leagues to look at ways to get things going again. I don't know. Maybe it's the sponsors that are pushing it, but it doesn't seem like there's a point to get that, especially if, like, you know, if there's things that are going to get lifted out of the lockdown, you would expect football to be one of the last things, right? Considering the amount of variables, you want as little variables as possible to open up first so that you can kind of stem the tide, I would imagine, right? Because if you just open the floodgates and said everyone go back to normal, you would inevitably have loads of people going to hospital at the same time, right? I'd imagine that's why. So I don't necessarily see why they couldn't just cancel it now so that people could get prepared and mentally ready for the next season. It just doesn't make that much sense. And, you know, do players, I know players have been sitting on their bum or, you know, for a couple of weeks, but do players really want to go to playing from not doing anything and then go to playing two times in a week for what, like 2 months? Is that what is necessary to complete the league? It's a bit much. It continues here. It said, they're talking about not playing in front of fans until 2021. If it's not safe enough for fans in the middle of a stadium, why would it be safe for players to be there? The Premier League has been suspended since the 30th of March. It's a really fair question, actually. Because of the COVID-19 pandemic, and most teams have 9 fixtures left to play. Dini said Watford were outside of relegation zone on goal difference when the season was halted. Hanley Norwich, bottom of the table, 6 points for positional safety. Other players, including defender Danny Rose and Man City Sergio Aguero and Raheem Sterling, have also previously raised their concerns about it, which is good, because I think once you get these players from all different, you know, from all different clubs who are sit in different positions in the Premier League, it gives their reason and their rationale more credence. People are going to listen to it more. If it was just like the top 4 clubs complaining or the clubs at the bottom, they'll just be like, oh, because you're going to get relegated because you've got too much money. But I guess because it's even spread of players across the league, I think they don't have any other opinion option but to listen. And if they don't, then I feel that the fans are going to take the side of the players, and they're going to, even though some of the fans will probably be gagging for football to come back so they could, you know, spend some time away from the family, which they have been, you know, handcuffed to these last few months or last couple of months. They're also under, you know, they would also be being more sympathetic to the players, because they just know it's not fair to be in a position where you have no voice and you're required to play at your best level, you know, with 3 weeks training or something, with hoping you don't get an injury. Because that's what's really going to happen. Once everyone gets back, we're going to see a real spike in injuries. It continues here, says Culture Secretary Oliver Dowden said on Thursday that football will return if it's safe to do so, and the health and welfare of players and coaches comes first. It's such a non-comment though, isn't it, that? It's like me saying Christmas is going to come again. Just wait for it. It's like, it's a non-comment. It doesn't say anything about the dates or what kind of health procedures they're going to put in place. Nothing. It's just it's going to come back. Like, okay, cool. He added here, I think the overall feeling the players have got concerns, says defender Hanley. There's just so much uncertainty. He says here, the 28-year-old says the following. My missus is pregnant and she's due at the start of July. So it's obviously worries there for myself. Every team and players have got their different views on it. Some lads have obviously got vulnerable family members or whatever. Oh, true. I didn't think about that as well. It's just so difficult to see 5 or 6 days in front of us or anything past that. Ultimately, it's putting our family at risk that is the main concern. And that's the worry I think a lot of teams will have at this minute in time. Which kind of goes back to this, you know, I think everyone's kind of realizing that it looks like the easy option was to lock things down, right? That was a thing that everyone did in unison across the world, and because it was an easy choice to make, there wasn't anything else to do. No one really knew how to attack things. But now we've got more information, it appears like the actual the separation between who's doing it things right or wrong is how they react in terms of opening up and what they do. That's where the actual creativity, ingenuity, foresight, and just maybe a strategy or, you know, whatever that may be comes into play. That's where you really earn your bucks. Like, how do you open things up? Because eventually things will have to open up, innit? We can't be indoors forever. Companies can't survive, you know, off the back of delivering Uber Eats. They're going to have to go back to normal some way, shape or form. It's just how do you do it and how soon? That's the real marker of if you actually know what you're doing. And for the most part, most of these governments, most of these governors, most of these MPs, mayors and stuff, and politicians don't have a fucking clue. They don't know. They've never actually dealt with any kind of crisis, which is really, which is kind of concerning, isn't it? Because you'd imagine, you know, one of the main remits, one of the main stipulation or requirements for somebody that's working in office would be how you deal with that, how you respond under pressure, right? What creative ways can you come around and kind of fix an issue, fix a problem? And if you can't do that, then why do we need you? Because everyone knows how to celebrate good times. We all know how to put a parade on, a street party, right? The actual real moneymaker is, can you get your constituents out of this slump? Can you pull them out from beneath and make things right again? And most politicians are proving that they cannot, really, innit? They're all struggling, like, fuck, man. Like my hair is at the moment. My hair is struggling. Oh, God. But what can you do?